Usually when a new video game drops, all of us are super excited. I'm excited, you're excited. We just wanna play this game for the next few days and just have a good time, right? Wrong, because...
racist.
Tales of Kenzera Zau just dropped, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm super excited to play this game. But you know what I've seen online? Stupid. And I just can't, you know what? Let's just start the video. For those of y'all that don't know, my name is Fly Guy GBG. If you like this kind of content, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, turn on those notifications, and hit your boy with a like. It really helps me out. But
let's get into the stupid stuff today.
Can someone explain to me how when you see this beautiful game, this colorful, vibrant game, that the first thing you think of is Sweet Baby Ink? And some of you guys claim that you were gonna get this game because you were really looking forward to it, but because of a consulting company, now you don't wanna get the game. Now I'm gonna show you guys some stuff that I've seen on Twitter, and I'm not gonna lie, if you don't get on Twitter, Twitter's not a real place, or X. X is not a real place, it's ridiculous. Let's get to it. Cabrutus Rambo says, sup guys, just wanna remind that Zau is gonna launch today. This game is on Sweet Baby Ink Detective Curator page, and yes, it's connected to Sweet Baby Ink. Remember to vote with your wallet. And if you don't know, Sweet Baby Ink is a consulting company that consults with gaming companies to include diversity and inclusion, right?
Does that sound like a bad thing?
Not really, but
you would be wrong.
After that initial tweet, more people started voicing their opinion on why they don't want to buy this game. And realistically, none of it makes sense. Frank Zarell says, you're damn right. I don't need a curator list. If it has a female and or black protagonist, I'm not playing it. It just kind of pisses me off because you saying all that stuff, all them words. And you could have just said, they claim it's because of Sweet Baby Ink, and that's not really true. We know what it really is. Just say it. And then they'll mention Barrett from Final Fantasy or something like that and say, oh, he's a cool character, but you only really like him because he's a side character. If he was the main character, you would have issue with that. Just saying. David Jackson 911 says, you could tell even if it wasn't on the list, meaning wasn't on the Sweet Baby Ink list. And because he said this, people were questioning what he actually meant, but we know what he meant. But people are still gonna defend him. Why you assumed his conclusion based on racism? He didn't even say the reason, and for me, the color grading gave me the vibe, though.
Really? A colorful video game gave you the vibe that a consulting company helped consult with the video game.
So we all saw the creator of Tales of Kenzera pour his heart out because he said that this game is a representation of him grieving his late father and whatnot. And still, the first thing we tie to this game, not that a man had a vision, is a company that consults. That's stupid. Blood, the fucking dude in the cover looks like an androgynous female cosplaying as a... You see what it says? Bro, have you never seen an African shaman before? Like, ever? Never? Never in your life. Okay. Sure. But, regardless, that last part, super unnecessary, and, you're kind of corny. That's all. JoJo's Bizarre Adventure says, consultation is literally an advisory job on what to do or not to do. So yes, they definitely insisted that the poster look like this to appeal to minorities and the diverse gamers. It's dead on arrival though. It's a game about African folklore. Of course the cover character will be black. Wait till the game includes LGBTQ and all that. Then you'll tell me African lore permits that. So only minorities like colorful posters?
White people say they don't see color.
Hey, my brother from another mother, man, all I got to say to you is the LGBTQIA+ fucking exists. They are people. They are on this goddamn planet. So if they're in a video game as well, I don't give a damn. And as far as it being historically accurate, it has African influence because a man from Africa created the game, but it does not have to be historically accurate. You dumb.
George Garcia, the game always smelled like a DEIESG fest. No thanks.
I just need you to explain this to me because maybe I'm missing it, right? But people say stupid things all the time, but if you can explain this to me, I'm down for it, big dog. So, how can an African game with an African protagonist, with African roots, all of that,
be DEI?
How? DEI in this case would be a white man playing the shaman. Just throwing it out there for you.
This game was conceived and developed by a black man as a love letter to his deceased father and his culture. Where is this forced diversity?
And you know how you know it's fake? It's because he says SBI got involved at all.
You know how you know it's crazy? It's because they say that we need to create our own characters, create new original characters, and they won't get mad about black protagonists and stuff like that. But then when you see it actually happening, they're still mad about black protagonists. This is insane to me. I don't get it. Someone help me.
What we say to DEI infested games? Not today. Either you don't know what DEI means or you do know what DEI means, and DEI to you just means woke, black, or whatever else. That's what DEI means to you.
That sucks so bad because I actually think the game looks good. Well, buy it.
If you think it looks good, it shouldn't matter anything else but the fact that you know you can have fun on the game. So buy it.
But he probably won't because he's going to claim SBI was involved and whatnot, but that's not really the thing. He wasn't going to buy it at all anyway, and we know why.
If you have no interest in this game, that's completely fine. But if you have no interest in this game,
based on bigotry,
you're a trash person. That's all I'm going to say about that. Personally, I'm playing the game. I do enjoy it so far. I've unlocked a few different powers at this point, but I'm still kind of in the beginning, so I am going to keep playing it. I kind of want to do a Prince of Persia like comparison to this. It is kind of different, Prince of Persia. I kind of jumped into action a little faster, but I don't know. I'm going to enjoy the game, but if you guys want to go ahead and check me out on Kick when I do stream, go ahead and check me out. Link will be in the description below. Probably won't work, but it'll be down there. You can copy and paste if you need to. I don't really know. But if you guys do like this kind of content, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Turn on those notifications if you are new, and go ahead and hit your boy with a like. It really helps me out. But I'm going to go ahead and get up out of here because this was nerve-wracking.
It's a new year. I'm a new type of nigga. Left a few partners in my pockets got bigger. I got new